20 to 7. It's 100 years almost since, well, it's exactly 100 years since one of the most decisive gains for Allied troops during World War I. And a ceremony has taken place to what has been described as a daring mission.
Yes, let's have a look at a striking image now that was taken following the capture of Rietveld Bridge. It was a major turning point for the Allies in the fight to break Germany's Hindenburg line. Let's talk about this now with the military historian Spencer Jones, who is here with us this morning. It's just an incredible, incredible picture there. I think we've got another one behind us here showing the bridge. How significant a moment was this?
Well, this was a moment that had significance just beyond the fact that the Allies, the British Army here, has captured a very important bridge. It's the only bridge over the San Quentin Canal that could take heavy traffic, so artillery, tanks and trucks. But the bridge itself doesn't tell the whole story. What this represents is the breaking of the Hindenburg Line. You may not know, but the Hindenburg Line had been constructed by the German army in 1916 and 17 as the most fortified zone on earth, the most heavily defended sector of the Western Front, and it was this line that they were going to stake their hopes on for getting any kind of result from the war in 1918.
Just for people who don't know, just explain what the Hindenburg Line was. Was it a supply route?
No, the Hindenburg Line was part of the Western Front.
Okay.
It was built as sophisticated as possible. Deep dugouts to protect the German infantry from artillery. Barbed wire emplacements, anti-tank traps, artillery, everything that could protect the defenders from the British attackers, the most heavily fortified zone on earth in 1918.
So what happened? We're seeing, look at this, modern day pictures of the bridge now. What happened here and how did they manage it?
Well, this was a very daring attack that was undertaken by 46th North Midland Division. The key element that seized the bridge was actually a 10-man unit led by a chap called Captain Arthur Charlton, who volunteered at the age of 22. He joined the Veterinary Corps in 1914. By 1918, he was leading men into action, and they burst through the fog at 10 minutes to 6, 100 years ago to this day, burst through the fog, overwhelmed a German machine gun nest at the end of the western end of the bridge, that's the Allied end, burst onto the bridge, overwhelmed the engineers who were trying to detonate the bridge and destroy it, and Charlton himself actually cut the cords on the explosives and threw them into the river to ensure the bridge fell into Allied hands.
So that is incredible. It is now 6:45 in the morning. So at around this time, within this hour, 100 years ago, this was happening.
Absolutely.
Do you think the men who were doing this had any clue as to how significant a moment this would be?
I don't think at the time they did. I think they were just more concerned with getting across the bridge, getting across the canal, surviving the battle. And actually afterwards there was some reflection by some of the soldiers that will this be remembered? I think as we're sat here now, we've proven that in fact it is.
And just how crucial was that moment then in, I mean, did it, was it a crucial moment in hastening the end of the war, or would it already have happened possibly anyway?
No, it was a decisive moment in itself. It was part of a wider Allied offensive that was going along all on the line, American, Australian, Allied troops, British and French troops in action. But this moment where the Hindenburg Line was broken at the Rietveld Bridge was crucial.
Because it was only weeks, wasn't it? Sorry, exactly. I didn't mean to interrupt, sorry.
It convinced the German High Command that the Hindenburg Line couldn't be held. They'd pit all their hopes on holding this line until the winter and perhaps getting a negotiated settlement. Once it was broken, the German commanders went to the Kaiser and told him the war had to end.
And this moment is being remembered this weekend, isn't it? At a special ceremony. How important is it that individual moments like this through the war are remembered?
I think it's very important, especially a moment such as this that is so decisive for the end of the war. It's easy to just think of the First World War as futility and waste, but ultimately it did end in an Allied victory. It did end in the liberation of Western Europe, and without that, the history of Europe, the geography of Europe would be entirely different.
I read something that you'd said about, sorry, we're pretty much out of time, but it's fascinating, isn't it, when you talk about what's and ifs and maybes. The fact that they weren't able to negotiate a settlement, that they were forced into the Treaty of Versailles, that Hitler rose to power. I mean, history could have been completely different if they... It's incredible.
Absolutely. We could be looking at a completely different map of Europe, a completely different timeline of history. We could talk about it for hours.
It's fascinating.
Spencer, it is properly lovely to talk to you. Thank you very, very much indeed. Incredible images.
Just amazing. And so you can never forget, can you, the bravery and the courage.
And 10 men. That was an operation of an advance party of 10 men.
Humbling, isn't it?
Yeah.